Warm greetings to the jury member, the organizers, and my dear viewers. This is Sakshi Chauhan, currently staying in Mohali, pursuing my Bachelor of Education from Chandigarh College of Education, Londra. As we all know, the declamation competition is organized on the occasion of 400th birthday celebration of Shri Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji. So on this memorable day, let's go through his life's journey and some precious teachings given by him to the mankind. Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji is the ninth Guru of the Sikhs. He was the youngest son of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji. He was born on April 1, 1621 at Amritsar. His mother was Bibi Nanki Ji. His birth name was Tyag Mal, but keeping in view of his courage and bravery, he was named Tegh Bahadur. At the time of his eternal rest, Guru Har Krishan Sahib Ji bowed down saying, Baba Bakale, means my successor is at Bakala. Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji meditated at Bakala for about 20 years with his wife and mother. The Mughal Emperor of India, Aurangzeb, attempted to consolidate India into one Islamic nation. In order to achieve this aim, he set out to virtually eliminate Hinduism from India. When the ninth Guruji heard of this from a group of Hindus, he challenged the emperor. As a result, the Guru was imprisoned at the request of Aurangzeb. Three devout Sikh who accompanied the Guru were arrested and martyred in front of Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji at Delhi. Despite being forced to watch the torture and the execution, Guruji simply refused to concede the emperor's demand. The emperor gave him three options: to embrace Islam, to perform miracles, or be ready for death. Finally, the Guru preferred the latter. His head was chopped off publicly at Chandni Chowk in Delhi on November 11th. Unparalleled in the history of humankind, the martyrdom of Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib Ji was an act of sacrifice for another religious community. The Guruji's martyrdom served to awaken the collective conscience of the Sikh community, which was about to undergo a final transformation in the years to follow. Guru Tegh Bahadur composed 116 Shabads and 15 Rags, and his teaching have been included in Adi Granth. Let's look back on some of his quotes and teachings derived from them. The one who vanquishes his ego and beholds the Lord as the sole door of all things, that person has attained the Jivan Mukti. The one who grieves not in misery and delights not in pleasure, who is free from fear and attachment, for whom the gold and dust are the same, and one who has renounced both praising and blaming, is immune to greed, worldly attachments and pride. When all the merciful Guru blesses a disciple with his grace, only then does the disciple attain this blessed spiritual state and blends with the Lord as the water with water. So if we inculcate some of his teachings in ourselves, I believe that will be the most wonderful thing for fighting back in this pandemic. And I'm very thankful to the team that they have given us such a beautiful platform to motivate each other and help each other by grasping the knowledge and teachings of given by Shri Tegh Bahadur Ji. Thank you so very much. Stay home, stay safe, serve the mankind, believe in God. Vaheguru Ji Di Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Di Fateh.